What's up, everybody? Welcome to A New English Bit. In today's lesson, we're going to learn interesting vocab with the word suit. Are you ready to increase your vocabulary? So take a notebook and let's kick off. Before we start, it's important to stress the pronunciation of the word suit. It's usually mispronounced, as a lot of people say sweet, sweet, but the correct pronunciation is suit. So U is long and letter I is silent. Suit, suit. For example, please wear a suit tomorrow. It's an important meeting. So now let's get started. The first word we're going to learn today is suitable. Suitable. It's an adjective and it means appropriate, acceptable, or right. For example, I'm confident I would be suitable for this job. It's a good sentence to use in your application letter. And the opposite of suitable is unsuitable. For example, this film is unsuitable for children. Let's continue number two, the noun suitability. Suitability. The opposite would be unsuitability. Unsuitability. For example, don't doubt about your suitability for this job. You'll do it great. Let's move on to number three, the verb to suit. Exactly the same as the noun, to suit. It means to be right, convenient, or useful for someone. Here are some examples. The first one, this course will suit your needs. Another one, would it suit you to meet at 5 p.m. tomorrow? And one more, working shifts wouldn't suit him. Let's continue number four, the phrasal verb to suit up. To suit up. It has two meanings. The first one is to wear a suit or to put on a suit. For example, Barney from the series How I Met Your Mother used to say a lot, suit up, because he loved wearing a suit for almost every occasion. For example, Ted, suit up. And the second meaning of the phrasal verb to suit up is to get ready for something big or something important. For example, imagine that your friend is getting married tomorrow, and you can say, suit up for your big day tomorrow. Let's move on to our expression number five. It suits somebody. It suits somebody. It means to make somebody look attractive and good. We usually use this expression to talk about colors, clothes, or hairstyle. And now let's look at some examples. For example, pink suits you. Another example, this dress suits you. You should definitely buy it. And one more example, that new haircut really suits him. Let's continue another expression. Number six, suit yourself. It's an informal expression that means do what you want to do. It can be used angrily or humorously. In Spanish is haz lo que quieras. And now two examples. The first one, I won't go to the party in the end. Suit yourself. And another example, I think you shouldn't spend so much money on clothes, but suit yourself. And now let's look at some idioms. Number seven, in your birthday suit. It means naked or without clothes. For instance, we were walking along the beach and all of a sudden we saw a man in his birthday suit. Let's continue another idiom. Number eight, somebody's strong suit. I like it very much and it means something you're good at. It's another way to say your strength. For example, creating content is my strong suit. What about you? What is your strong suit? Let me know in the comments below. Second to last idiom, to follow suit. It's level C2 and it means to do the same thing as somebody else. For example, if parents read, children will follow suit. And to finish, the British informal expression, suited and booted. It means to look very smart and wear formal clothes. For example, look at him, all suited and booted. I bet he's going to a wedding. So I really hope you enjoyed this English bit and learned some interesting expressions and idioms. If you did, don't forget to like this video, to share it with your friends and family, to subscribe to the channel and follow me on Instagram. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!